So now, friends, we are discussing about today the explanation of law of demand. In my previous lecture, we have completed what we mean by the law of demand. Law of demand, that means when all other factors are constant due to change in price, how demand will be changed. Because of in here, price is cause and effect is demand. Okay, so due to, it is a relationship between price and demand. So due to change the price, what type of demand is changed? This relation we will explain in the law of demand. Here, price is the cause and demand is effect. Got it? Here, I said that when all other factors are as before, when all other factors are constant, in that condition only this law of demand will be work. This law was presented by the Alfred Marshall. And he said that when all other factors are constant, due to change, when all other factors are constant, due to change the price, demand also will be changed. So demand remains due to when other factors increasing, demand remains unchanged. If price of a good falls, its demand expands. And if price of goods rises, demand is contract. That means what? When all other factors are constant, due to change the price, demand also will change, and it is called law of demand. And it shows the relationship between price and demand, the cause and effect relationship. Here, cause is the price and effect is demand. So in this law, price of the cause variable. What is the variable? Price of the cause, which is cause, it is variable. And demand is effect variable. Okay, friends. What type of variable? Effect variable. This law was presented by Professor Alfred Marshall. I already done. And some assumptions are here. If we will follow this assumption, then only our law of demand will work. Otherwise, law of demand will not work. These assumptions are, first one is taste and preference is as before, no change in the consumer's taste and preference. Second one is income of the consumer is unchanged. Price of substitute goods, complementary goods unchanged. Consumer do not make. So when this all R remains same in this condition only, law of demand will be work. Correct, friends? Otherwise, law of demand will not work. Now next one is the, we are going to explain next one, which is related to explanation of the law of demand. Explanation of law of demand. Explanation of law of demand in this first one, we have to complete law of demand, already completed, so no need to write again. How it is work, we will discuss today first this one. Schedule. We can explain law of demand with the help of the schedule, diagram and reasoning provided below. First one is schedule. We are discussing about schedule diagrams. And then after we will discuss about the reasoning. First one, what is the demand schedule? It is a question in your textbook also. What is the demand schedule? Demand schedule means which showing the willingness of the consumer. Which is showing the willingness of the consumer to buy different qualities of a good at various prices is called demand schedule. Dear friends, what do we mean by the demand schedule? Demand schedule showing willingness of a consumer to buy different qualities a good at various prices. It is called demand schedule. And we can explain this one by this example. In this example, one side is related to price of milk in rupees. Okay. Second side is given, which is the demand of milk in liters. I said as before, if price will be rise up, that means demand will be falls down. If demand price will be fall down, if prices fall down, demand will be rise up. And if price is fall down, demand will be. If prices rise up, then demand will be fall down. If prices fall down, then demand will be rise up. So what type of relations? Inverse relations. Clear, friends? We are discussing here the demand schedule. Demand schedule meaning already I completed the schedule showing willingness of a consumer to buy different qualities of good at various prices. It's known as demand schedule. Clear? 1 mark question. It's IMP question for 1 mark. So remember that. Next one is table. We are explaining table here. Price of milk 50, 40, 30, 20, and 10. When price is 50, that time consumer will demand only 1 liter milk. When price is 40, then its demand is 2 liter. Correct, friends? If price is 30, then demand is 3 liter. When price is 20, then demand is 4 liters. And if price is 10, then demand is 5 liter. That means what? Due to fall the price, demand is increasing. And due to rise the price 10 to 20, then it will be 5 to 4. Then 20 to 30, it will be 4 to 3, like that. So it is what type of relation? Inverse relationship. Clear, friends? Next one, we will explain about this diagram. Okay. In this diagram, we are getting the relationship. Actually, there are different ways to present the law of demand. First, we have explained by the demand schedule. Then we explained by the table. Now we are explaining by the diagram. In this diagram, OX axis and OY axis. It is OX, it is OY. On the OX axis, demand of milk is given here in liters. On the OY axis, price of milk is given on this OY axis. It is OY axis. Correct, friends? So on this demand, price of a milk has given in rupees. It is what type of what axis? It is OX axis. And on this axis, what is given? Demand. Okay, demand of what commodity? Milk. You can write apple also if you want. You can write apple, oranges, and anything. And food packets. So here, if price is 50, then 1 liter milk. So you can write here, you can draw diagram from 50 rupees price, and because of the 50 rupees price and how much unit required or demanded by the consumer, only and only 1 liter milk. When price is 40, then demand has how much? Demand is 2 liter milk. Correct, friends? Demand is 2 liter milk. So this point, B point, we can get. When price is 30 rupees, 30 rupees, so 30 rupees price and demand is how much? 3 liters. When price has 20 rupees per liter, that time demand has 4 liters. Last one, when price has 10 rupees, that time demand has how much? Demand has 5 liters. So which point we got? We have got A, B, C, D, E. And this curve slope is left to right downward. Why its curve slope is left to right downward? Because of it is showing the inverse relationship between price and demand. Due to that reason, its slope is left to right downward. Correct, friends? Its slope. Curve slope is left and downward because of it is showing the inverse relationship between price and demand. Correct, friends? Same type of explanation is given. We will have got A, B, C, D points, and DD is the which slope? Demand slope. Demand curve. Okay. Next one is analysis and reasons for the inverse relationship between price and demand. I said that the curve slope is left right downward. This type of slope, demand curve slope, is left right downward. Why it's curve slope left right downward? Because of reason is what? Here we have drawn this diagram left right downward. This curve, we got this curve A, B, C, D. This is A, it is B, then see if we will join those all points, we will get a curve. And what's curve name? DD. It is D curve. And on this curve, slope is left, right, downward. Because of it is showing inverse relationship between price and demand. Why? By which reason it has inverse relationship? We will discuss now this one. It has inverse relationship because of first one reason is